Welcome to EnjoyTheMusic.tv and EnjoyTheMusic.com to our CES 2015 live stream. We're here with Dan D'Agostino of Dan D'Agostino Master Audio Systems. Now, Dan has been doing this for, like, basically ever. I remember you back in the Krell days, and now you're making these incredible amplifiers. So, Dan, why don't you tell us a little about them?
Oh, thank you, Steve. Our whole genesis here at Dan D'Agostino is to make amplifiers that are very musical and also beautiful. I think that things that are beautiful seem to look better, sound better, but more relaxing to the eye, and I think that it makes the music part more enjoyable. You know, we build everything by hand. Everything's hand-matched, hand-assembled. All the parts are procured in the United States. Our metalwork is made in Colorado. All of our parts are U.S.-based companies. So we like the fact that we're all made in U.S. We build everything in Carefree, Arizona. We moved there a year ago from Connecticut, kind of get out of the cold and give me a cheery disposition with the sunshine every day.
Oh, I know it. Right now, just so you know, it is 10 degrees where I'm at. It was -7 this morning.
Wow. That's no fun.
No. That's without wind chill. So anyway, you've got this new amplifier that you announced at CES. Why don't you tell us about it?
Okay, well, we decided that we would reach into the cinema market a little bit because I think there's a demand for very high-powered, you know, great-sounding amplifiers for people with cinema. So we made this amplifier that's three channels. It's 250 watts times three. It's also is doubles its power as the impedances have. So at 2 ohms, it's 1,000 watts, all channels driven.
Wow.
It's got a 3.5 kilowatt power supply in it, so it's huge. It's RS-232 controllable, so you can tell whether it's on or off. It'll also tell you if there's a fault. Along with that, we added crossovers for each channel, so you can have a high pass or low pass at 18 dBs per octave at 80 hertz. So it gives you some big versatility. You can also bridge two of the channels for 1,000 watts at 8 ohms.
So it's a big powerhouse. You can use it for bi-amping or supplying for home theater or home audio.
Right.
Very
exactly.
Really flexible there.
And we want to sell it in three versions. It's for three channels, it's $15,900. And for two channels, it's $12,900. And if you want just a big stereo amplifier without the RS-232, without the crossovers, it's $12,000, and it's called a classic when that's there. So it's just a big, you know, high-performance amplifier.
Well, definitely sounds it. And you've got some other, we were talking actually earlier before we went live here, and I love the design. Why don't you tell them all the effort you took to actually make the visual design of some of your amplifiers?
Well, you know, 4 years ago or 5 years ago, when I started this company, you know, I wanted to build something that was beautiful, something that just was so different, but also something that was very functional. And I started working with copper, and copper seemed to be the answer for me to make a small package. I didn't want to make a great big amplifier, but I also didn't want to, you know, leave my roots, which is to make really high-powered amplifiers.
Uh-huh.
But copper became a really good factor in that, and then the sculpting of the front panel was like a vision I've had for a long time, but I've never been able to put it on paper and make it look good. But after a lot of 3D renderings and a lot of scaling and dimensioning, I've got that look down pretty good, and we've refined it since we first designed it. And it was fun because, you know, we really are making stuff that looks like audio jewelry.
Yes.
Yeah, and I like the fact that I can put some of the things that have been, you know, important to me in my life, watches and cars, and I kind of wanted to make something that when you unwrap it, it's like an expensive watch, and when you see the detail on the knob and the meter, which kind of drags in watches, and some of the early Bugatti gauges where they stuck out of the dashboard.
Yes.
So I grab all those things when I put the styling together.
Well, I'm a car guy and a watch guy, so I completely understand. When Roth, if you want, we'll talk briefly about watches.
Yep.
So let's get to the next amp, or you had a, I'm trying to remember the next item you wanted to talk about.
The next item is the Momentum Lifestyle. And that is our integrated amplifier, which we released last year, which has 200 watts of channel, and it uses all of the same boards and parts as we use in our Momentum stereo and preamp. So they sound exactly alike, except that it's all in one package. So this year we took that package and we took our tone controls out and we put a screen in, streaming audio and from Stream Unlimited, and we have our own app that we generated.
Wonderful.
And it's part of our system. So you have extreme convenience. It comes with its own access point and an iPod Touch already programmed with our app. Our app works for Android or for iPhone.
Nice.
The app has all of the different functions. You can do every function that's on the front panel of the preamp amplifier, but you also can select how you want to play the music: AirPlay, Bluetooth, USB. All those things are available to you. It also has SPDIF input on the rear panel for digital. It comes with Tidal.
Which is the high, for those not familiar with Tidal, it actually is CD quality streaming music.
Yeah, and it'll work with any media server. You know, if you have a server in your house, it'll find it and show you that, and you can play all that through it. Mm-hmm. It's very user friendly. Like I said, it's got Tidal, Pandora, Spotify, all of those different sources. And then you have all of the functions that the integrated has, plus you have the streaming media, and it's very seamless and it works extremely well, and it's also beautiful.
Which again is what I love about your gear, is that, you know, and I know that, like, oh, there you go. Here, let me go right back to you real quick.
Can you see that?
Yes.
That's our app.
Wow, whoever did the graphics did a great job.
Yeah, they did.
The shadowing, the way it pops out is beautiful.
Yeah, that was done with a lot of work from our digital engineer, Francesco, and my wife, Petra, who did all of that that shading, scaling, and the look.
Well, they're great with Photoshop or whatever program they're using.
Yes, absolutely.
You're a lucky man. So it's really a family. That's the other thing with high-end audio. It's really a family business, isn't it?
It has become one. You're right. Yes.
I mean, even your son now is doing his thing.
Yeah, he's got his own business, and he seems to be doing fine with that.
Not good.
Yeah.
So what else would you like to tell us today?
Well, only that we're continuing to develop some products. We're in the works midst of putting the design together for a headphone amp that's going to have the Stream stuff in it, just like the preamp.
Mm-hmm.
So it'll be a very cool headphone amp. We're projecting a price of around $10,000 for it. And we're busy working on our new product line called Progression, which we intend to display at the Munich show for the first time.
Well, I will be at Munich, so I look definitely forward to seeing it there.
Yeah, definitely. That'll be a fun thing.
Wonderful. Any last words or other things you'd like to fit
in? You know, we're there. We're in Arizona. Anyone that ever wants to visit us, get out of the cold weather, please give us a call. We'd love to show you around.
Just rubbing it in as it's, you know, -7 this morning.
Take you to some of the cowboy bars. And
wonderful.
Fun with us.
Thank you so much for your time. We really do appreciate it.
Thank you.
Oh, and that was Dan D'Agostino, who was kind enough to take his time and have us go forward. And again, my name is Stephen Rochlin with enjoythemusic.com and enjoythemusic.tv. And as always, in the end, what really matters is that you enjoy the music.